Every time you solve a captcha, knowingly or unknowingly, you're helping to digitize a book. To know how this is possible, let's go back to the year 2000 when captcha was invented. The chief scientist of Yahoo at that time gave a talk at the Carnegie Mellon University to the PhD students on 10 problems Yahoo was trying to solve and challenged everyone on the campus to solve any one of these problems. One of the problems on the list was of spam emails. During those days, Yahoo Mail service was used by millions of people and new users kept signing up every day for free accounts. Among these new signups, a large chunk was made up of bots, which created spam email IDs used to send spam emails. At that time, a Yahoo email account limited users to send just 500 emails a day. Hence, hackers would write programs to create millions of emails accounts for sending spam emails, and Yahoo did not know how to stop them. Somewhere in that crowd was a young PhD student named Louis Von Ahn. He solved this problem. Louis started working with his PhD advisor to develop a program that distinguished a human from a computer. The program displayed squiggly letters or numbers and required users to type out the characters shown. As humans can read the distorted characters easily and computers can't do it well, it helped to distinguish between a human and a bot. He named the technology CAPTCHA, which stands for Completely Automated Public Turing Test, to tell computers and humans apart to prevent automated signups. After building the technology, Louis handed it to Yahoo for free and it worked like a charm. Yahoo's spam problem got solved overnight, and within few years, a large number of websites on the internet started using CAPTCHA to prevent spam. Even though the technology was good, hackers and spammers figured out ways to outsmart the technology by creating programs capable of reading and cracking CAPTCHA. Hence, in 2005, Louis launched a second version of CAPTCHA. He named it ReCAPTCHA. This time around, Louis decided to not just make the system more secure, but make it more useful as well, as he realized that despite just taking few seconds to type a CAPTCHA, on a larger scale, humans were spending hundreds of thousands of hours each day typing in more than 100 million CAPTCHAs. Hence, he thought of using ReCAPTCHA to digitize books and newspapers. Basically, to digitize a book, first the book is scanned by taking a picture of each page. Then a computer takes the image of each word and converts it into text using optical character recognition. But computers often come across printed words they just can't recognize, especially for older documents, things that were written before 1900 where the ink has faded and the pages have yellowed out. ReCAPTCHA takes advantage of this glitch in the digitization process. Each new word that cannot be read correctly by OCR is given to a user in conjunction with another word for which the answer is already known. The user is then asked to type in both the words. If they solve the one for which the answer is known, the system assumes their answer is correct for the new one. The system then gives the same image to a number of other people to determine with higher confidence whether the original answer was correct. In just first year after launching this ingenious system, ReCAPTCHA, humans currently deciphered and transcribed more than 440 million words, roughly equivalent to 17,000 books. ReCAPTCHA has completely digitized the archives of the New York Times, where more than 13 million articles in total have been archived, dating from 1851 to the present day. It is also used to digitize books for websites like Internet Archive and Project Gutenberg. In September of 2009, Google acquired ReCAPTCHA and continued on this mission. In 2012, ReCAPTCHA began using images in addition to scanned words as CAPTCHAs. This helped to label images on the web as well and help computers recognize objects. You would have solved CAPTCHA where you have to select streetlight or signal or buses. All this is used to improve Google Street View and also to train Google's self-driving car Waymo to recognize obstacles. Nowadays, the no CAPTCHA ReCAPTCHA is used, where you just have to tick a box to say you are a human, or the new invisible ReCAPTCHA is used, where verification occurs in the background and no challenges are displayed at all if the user is deemed to be low risk. In case you're wondering what the genius behind this idea is doing, Louis Von Ahn, the creator of CAPTCHA, is the founder and CEO of Duolingo, one of the biggest free learning applications in the world. So this is how every time you solve a CAPTCHA, you help in digitizing books. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, then please consider subscribing to my channel and do watch out my other videos. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.